Today I'm going to talk about ancient Egypt with you guys. Oh yes, and today I was researching about ancient Egypt after my online classes, and I found out about a pharaoh that it was really interesting, so I wanted you guys to know about it too. So before we start on with her history, I want to tell you something. That all Egyptian history is by far the most oldest relic of history in the entire world. Oh yes, and all the pharaohs in Egypt have been man. In old Egypt, people believe that only man can be pharaohs and kings, you know, because even all the mythological gods like Anubis, Hugs and all those things, they were all man. So Egyptians believe that women cannot be pharaohs. But seven women have become pharaohs. And one of them is Hatshepsut. We're going to talk about her and her history today. So let's start. Hatshepsut was the daughter of King Thutmose I. Hatshepsut became queen of Egypt when she married her half-brother Thutmose II around the age of 12. Upon Thutmose II's death, she adopted an infant, Thutmose III. You see, Thutmose III's stepmother is Hatshepsut. And Thutmose III hated Hatshepsut a lot. And he was an infant, so he couldn't rule. So Hatshepsut took on full power and became the co-ruler of Egypt around 1473 BCE. As a pharaoh, he extended Egyptian trades and oversaw ambitious building projects, mostly the Temple of Dirda Bahir, located in Thebes, where she was buried. Hatshepsut was one of the most successful pharaohs of her time. Let's talk about Hatshepsut's death and what happened to Thutmose III. You know, I really hate Thutmose III. I don't know why. It's just that, wow, he is really hating his stepmother a lot. I'll tell you why I hate him. In the end of the video. Let's hear what Hatshepsut and when did she die. Hatshepsut died around 1458 BCE. She was buried in the Valley of Kings, located in the hills of Dilawabu. Now, let's hear what happened to King Thutmose III. King Thutmose III ruled for 30 years. He had all evidences of Hatshepsut. Okay, this is the part where I hate you, okay? Hatshepsut, so he tried to erase them but failed. Who tries to erase this step? Okay. but failed. I'll tell you why. Because in 1903, the British archaeologist Howard Carter discovered Hatshepsut's history and put her back on the pharaoh list. Thanks to Howard Carter for putting Hatshepsut back on the list. Very interesting history right here. So like, subscribe, share. Hope you enjoyed. And I'm going to see you guys next time. Goodbye.